Hey guys, what's up? This is Eric. My channel is mainly working on projects that cover everything from hardware to software. The projects I'm working on and sharing are very simple versions of projects, but I hope it's a good starting point for people who want to do certain projects. In this video, I'd like to introduce the Firebase client app for iOS and Android based on Flutter. The reason for using Flutter is simple, because it can be built for multiple platforms with one code. Of course, it doesn't work 100%. Sometimes it's necessary to have work on the native. As I mentioned in the simplest project I share, Flutter can be very useful. If you do Flutter the first time, then just try it. I think you can learn it in a fun way. As you know, if you are subscribing to my channel, I have worked on a project to keep updating temperature and humidity data from ES32 to Cloud Firestore on Firebase. As the next version of the project, a Flutter app easily signs in or signs up to Firebase, reads the values currently stored in Cloud Firestore, and shows them on the screen. The left one is the iPhone and the right one is Android. I will show you from the beginning about this app. The first time you run the app, you will see a welcome screen. When you press get started, the login screen appears. If you have already signed up, you can enter your registered email and password. If not, you need to press register to sign up. There are many ways to log in to Firebase, Gmail, Facebook, GitHub, Apple login, and so on, but I only allow email, which is a traditional method, so I can sign up and log in by email and password. I will try to log in with the email and password that I already created. If the login is successful, you will be taken to the dashboard screen. On this page, you can check the temperature, humidity, and a line chart, which is replaced on the right to show the simple trend. It's intended to check the rough trend only. For the detailed history, it's necessary to create an archive on additional history in Cloud Firestore. When a new temperature value is updated from ESP32, the app automatically updates the screen with new data. It works very well. And there is a button under the screen where you can sign out. Since Firebase also has login information, you don't need to re-login every time unless it has passed wrong time or sign out. This is a Firebase client application based on Flutter to be shared in this video. The link to the source code is in the description below. Please refer to this and use it. In this video, I will explain what I need to do to use Firebase SDK on Android and iOS. I don't explain the source code. Please leave your comment if you have a question about my code. Let's get started. I'm still using what I was created in the previous project. If you need the first part of the Firebase, please check my previous project videos. I will add the Android app from Firebase. The most important part is put the Android package name. If this part is wrong, the app will not work normally. Let's fill in all the parts one by one. When you download my project from GitHub, there are no Android iOS folders as shown in the project tab on the left. There is purely a source code only. You can create an iOS Android-based project through the command Flutter create. This will create a project of all platforms that you can build in your current development environment. I will remove macOS, test, and web folders except for Android and iOS because I don't need them. You can specify the package name of the Android app in the build grader of the app folder on Android. I will say com.devproject.iot.firestore.android. You can decide the name whatever you want. And I will make the minimum build version 21. This makes it easy to solve multi-dex problems without adding anything else. I will put this package name as the Firebase Android app package name. Skip name. The SSH1 fingerprint is required for authenticating with Google login or phone number. I will simply get it and put it in. Download the Google service JSON file. It shows what needs to be added to the Gradle to use Google services. I will copy and paste as it is. First, copy the downloaded Google service JSON file to the Android app folder. Open the build grader file in the Android root folder. Copy and paste the required parts. If you use Google Analytics, copy and put this part. My Android build is based on Kotlin, so I copy the Kotlin code. This completes the preparation of the Firebase SDK for Android. Don't forget to run a pubget in pubspec YAML file. Download all necessary packages on the app. I prepare an Android emulator. Let me run this app. There are some warning messages. This is not error. It says that some Java files use or override a deprecated API. There is nothing we can do because it needs to be updated, the package in Firebase. Build was successful and the app was installed on the emulator. If you press get started, you can sign in or sign up. I will try to sign up first. You can enter the dashboard as soon as you have signed up. Now you can see information about humidity and temperature here. Let me show you the Cloud Firestore page and see the update. You can see that it's updated with the new values. On the authentication page, you can check the information about the user who was signed up now. Android build for Firebase is finished. Next, let's prepare the iOS build. Add the iOS app from the project overview. Change the last part of the Android package name to iOS and register the app. Download the Google Service Info plist file. You must prepare a package for iOS using the Cocoa pod. If it's a native app, this part should be added, but the Flutter package contains this part, so let's skip it. Now let's go back to the project and prepare the parts we need. I will open the terminal to update the pod repository. It's recommended to update the new version information of the package regularly. It may take some time if there are some updates. You can open pod file for iOS to specify the target platform and specific version for packages. Since there are often packages that do not support version 9.0, I will change it to 10.0. Let's open the Xcode. It's recommended that you work on Xcode if there is something you need to do for iOS. Copy the downloaded Google Service Info plist file to the runner folder. And put the package name in bundle identifier. If this is not the same as the app in the Firebase, it will not work properly. Let's select the target iPhone simulator and try to build it. Oh, build fails. The reason is that the pod installation did not proceed. There is nothing to do in Xcode, so I will close it. Let me open the iPhone simulator. Let's run it again. If you look at the console, you can see that it's doing pod install. The required package was not installed because Xcode did not execute the pod install separately. Xcode starts to build and ends successfully. This process may take a few minutes. It depends on the performance. It works the same as Android application. It's great. This completes today's project. The source code is in the description below, and please ask questions about the code in the comments below this video. The connection between hardware and software is always interesting. Especially ESP32 has a really good price line, and we can make IoT devices of the style that we want using the built-in Wi-Fi and Bluetooth module. It also makes it easier to create applications using Flutter than other platforms. That's it for today. Thanks for watching. See you in the next project.